dude.
You're high?
What shit did you give me?
I know.
Brad gave me lace fucking food.
I can see in your eyes, dude. You're
so,
I'm telling you, it's the PCP. That's what all the fucking dealers are doing. They dip the blends in PCP.
Do not ever do PCP, by the way, guys. Don't ever do that. That's legit horrible. All
right, let's go.
How many are you doing?
I don't know.
20?
Maybe.
Easy 20.
If I fucking go like this, baby.
15 clean. 15 clean. Blue? Or just no tape?
Let's go.
You want to give him a lift off?
Yeah, let's go.
Give me a lift off?
Come on, bro.
I got you.
Be a good trainer.
I got you, dog. Let's go.
All right, 3, 2, 1.
Easy.
All right, now go on your phone.
Oh, yeah, like trainers?
Yep.
Yeah, it turns up.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah, keep going. Almost there, Steve. Good job, Steve. This is Chantley, real trainer. Do more, buddy. Keep going.
And then look at me, starts to fail.
Keep going.
And you're like, oh.
I'm.
Yeah, I know. I'm fucking with you. Let's go.
Easy.
Look how tricep dominant Steve is.
You get that powerlifting.
Yeah, he wants to use the tricep. Let's go.
Who taught you that?
Ah!
Who taught you how to bench like that? For real, though, I want to know. Huh?
Taught myself?
You know, most bros that bench, they just, you know, they do.
They're wide. They're
yeah.
more wide.
You got like, a little power, yeah.
That's pretty good, Steve.
Thank you.
Strong guy, bro.
Interesting.
There's a method to the madness.
Chest every day, all day. Back in high school.
You trying to say every day is chest day?
Every day is chest day.
Clearly, look. Every day is arm day for this guy. Bro.
Every day is chest day.
You want to arm wrestle for that title?
No, I wouldn't want to. I wouldn't want to hurt you, Brad.
You sure?
No, I like Brad too much. I wouldn't want to.
I wouldn't want
to. Sounds like a cop out. That's okay though. Put 3 on there.
All right, let's do this.
We need to drop an album soon, please.
All right.
And Steve don't spy you? That's messed up. He's doing 3 plates.
I like a new iPhone. Is that the iPhone 22?
Yeah. Nice. It's dope.
Nice. It's pretty hard.
Sick. It's got LTE.
Oh, LTE?
Yeah.
You want to video it?
No, I'm good. Okay. But I need a lift off.
I got you.
Come on.
I'll just pull.
Take your time, bro.
Go.
All right. 3, let's go.
Yep. 2.
Come on. Oh wow.
Good. That first rep was good.
Yeah.
Was it really good?
The second one was pretty bad.
Well, the second one, it goes low. The first rep, you went all the way down though. Where?
Here.
Super tricep dominant. Both sides even though?
Just this.
Yeah. He also presses with his lat too, which
never,
is good.
It never goes away.
Too much jerking off.
Maybe if you got a real massage, it'll help out.
Too much jerking.
I go to the...
Too much wacky jacky.
Well, no, I'm not left-handed. But I go to, in West Hollywood, Brad's Rub and Tug.
I don't have a Rub and Tug. Okay. I think 90% of the shit Steve says is bullshit, dude, at this point.
But anyways, they're not the best at massaging. They're good at the tugging part, but they kind of just rub you. And I don't know. The massage isn't there.
Massage isn't there?
Yeah.
Just the tug part?
Yeah,
so tug part's legit?
Yeah, legit. Maybe you could, I don't know, something you could work on.
Something to work on?
Improve the service? You're stupid, dude.
Oh, fuck.
405? How many?
Two.
Let's go. How do I feel?
I can just go like this. That's cool.
Is that cool?
That's fine, yeah. And then go back, we'll do a drop set.
Your tricep hurts?
I don't know, it's right. Like
your elbow, right there?
Elbow, yeah.
Maybe you right got tendonitis.
Right there. Yeah, it's...
Three, two,
yep. One.
But it's good work.
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I mean we're doing real reps here.
Yeah, yeah.
All the way.
Go. Up. Pull it down. Press.
Another one?
Drop set.
Cool drop set. Let's go. Four reps. Go. A little higher. Come on. Keep going. It's light. Get it up! Come on! All the way up, you fucker! All the way up!
Give me a bump,
got
Brad.
You. Come on, I got you. I mean, not a bump, just go. I'll bump it up. Go. Higher, you fuck! Go, higher.
Bro.
No.
That's failure.
It's so funny. He's like, my tricep hurts. So he goes closer.
Yeah, bro.
It's gonna make it hurt more if you go closer.
My elbow, it's like this right here.
It's not on this side.
Feel it, like right there.
Oh, it's on this side?
Yeah.
Not here.
No.
Oh, never mind.
That probably would help it. Steve knows naturally. That's pretty good. Pretty good, Steve.
How much do you think he weighs?
220.
220?
I think I've gained a lot of weight.
How much do you think, Steve? Too much to tell for the scale. Bro, you broke it. Get off of it.
Are you touching anything? Okay, hold on.
All right, go on now.
Now go? And don't touch anything.
Guess.
No, you gotta stay here. Just stay on it. It'll read. Stay on it.
Hello?
Yeah. Right there. Stay on. Okay. See?
211.
You just thought 190?
No, I said 200.
Okay.
211, that's not bad.
No, it's not bad at all. I thought you were 220 for sure. Good.
Why, because of strength or because of how he looks?
He just looks beefy, dude.
Yeah, you do.
He looks beefy. All
right, let's go. Boom. Easy. Come on. Oh, we gotta drop the weight, man. Oh. 55? Come on.
There you go. There you go. Oh, yeah. Ooh. Oh yeah. Okay.
The way he works out this.
Go! I love it. Like an animal.
Literally.
A fucking animal. It's funny.
It's funny.
He's an animal. Huh?
And then.
Yeah. There you go. Let it get lower. Elbows lower. Yeah, there you go.
Like a dance move. You okay?
Yeah, I just fell back.
You good?
Kyle hit the chest. Kyle's ahead of us right now. Go.
Let's go. Easy. Dude, every time. So you're saying...
Yeah, his shoulder's been fucked. Your shoulder's been fucked.
Shoulder's been fucked
for a little while, huh?
It's not the jerking off. It's not the jerking off.
It could be, but...
You sure?
Yeah. I've been switching to my left for jerking, so it can't be the jerking.
It's not the jerking. So he's coming to the gym, and every once in a while, he's like kind of complaining about the same thing for like about a month now, right?
2 months. Yeah, any fucking press.
Yeah.
It's just like when I turn my shoulder like this, it's just fucking... It's fucked back here. It's annoying, too, like to not be able to bench and shit properly.
Yeah,
shit. But the other day when Ray came, after he loosened me up, like after three sessions, like I went right back to benching like what I was benching.
I think because what it's doing is you're creating some space away from where the actual injury is. So like what happened to him is probably something, he got some scar tissue built up somewhere. And like that's one way of like creating space so that you can move more fluidly so you're not creating the pain. But like for you guys at home and for you, the things that are going to help you get better faster, because a lot of people would like to like, oh, should I just do one thing to get it better? But for him, it's like there's a few things you can do. Like you can take supplements that are going to help reduce inflammation. An Epsom salt bath is going to help take strain out, right? Getting soft tissue or like deep tissue work done on the area to help remove, like get everything back in alignment in a sense. And the Cairo stuff is all going to help. And stretching. Because it's obvious if you have pain here, you probably have some sort of like, because it's happening every time you press, some sort of like, you're creating
like
too much tension here.
Like here and then it's like back.
So guys, if you have issues in your shoulders, like try not to just think of just one thing. Like this, I know it sounds like a lot, but it's actually really simple. Some anti-inflammatory supplements, take some Epsom salt baths at night, obviously get more rest, drink more water, eat more food. It might be a recovery thing as well, but the soft tissue work, the chiro work is all gonna help. If you can get all that stuff, obviously it sounds like a lot. I would say probably the most important stuff is consistent stretching. Cause like likely if you have a problem in the back, it's probably because of something in the front.
What stretch should I do then?
Like this.
I've been doing that one, you said.
This one. Also lacrosse ball too.
Yeah. So you have different angles with the hand. Like check this out. So like if you did a stretch and you were here, you're gonna feel this more in your chest. The more you turn your hand, like you'll feel more in like your bicep and your shoulder. But I would say hand and elbow pretty flat and just sit into the stretch. But the thing is like the duration, a lot of people don't stretch long enough. Like you gotta do like a good 45 seconds both sides. A lot of people do like 15 and then 10. So, but if you stay consistent with the stretching, it's the easiest way. The stretching, there's a few supplements that I'll send you a list on to reduce inflammation. And then you, honestly, this is the part that sucks. Take time legit away from hitting chest. I know as much as that
sucks. That's the worst part.
But like that oftentimes will fix it. And then if you just focus on hitting back, you're gonna help balance that problem because it doesn't hurt when you hit back, right?
No, if I do it like dope, just like retract.
So focus on the things, normally the opposite muscle group of like wherever you're injured is probably gonna help. Because at the same time, understand this, people don't realize, you're gonna help build the stability, right? But at the same time, you're getting blood flow. Every time you contract, like when I contract my back, blood is flowing to my chest. When I contract my chest, blood is flowing to your back. So when you're doing movements, you're pushing blood in and out of the opposite, obviously all around your whole body, but the opposing muscle groups. And a lot of times if you have like an injury, like it's sometimes because there's not enough blood flow for your body to like properly remove it, because it, so then it just keeps sustaining. And obviously the stress of like having the scar tissue build up, not getting it worked on, and re-injuring is gonna make it worse, make it stay. So you have to take some time off. So you'll be good though.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna say you live for real. Yeah. Cool.
Crave cheat meals, bro.
I bet.
Crave.
I bet you though, if you were.
If I
fucking go to Ascend and I strike out, if I don't fucking slam a bitch, I'm 100% going to Jack in the Box. One or the other.
Dude.
If you strike out, I'm getting curly fries from Jack in the Box and I'm dipping them in ranch and fucking booing with the boys at the end of the night.
Bro, but it's crazy because if you like were able to sustain not doing it for like 2-3 months, like it, you'd change. And you'd be able to go back and forth and like have no problem. Like if you did do that, it wouldn't be a big issue. And then like you wouldn't have a 2-day thing, a 2-day hangover, you probably bounce back quicker. Because you'd just be in better shape overall. So I know it's a season.
No, Steve's a beast. He can still fuck.
Well, Steve, yeah, I mean, I don't even know if things affect Steve, to be honest.
Tyler ordering fucking Uber Eats, like, in our own fucking room, so we bet this guy's already hit a workout, fucking cooking eggs. Animal.
Well, Steve is a fucking alien, I think. Steve's an alien.
It's all the shit you give me, bro.
He might be an alien, bro.
That's something like that. Human Genome Project.
I think things don't affect Steve, to be honest. Crazy. Let's go. Don't pause at the bottom.
Can you give me a spot?
Yeah. One more.
Well, he wasn't in the video. Well, now you're in the video. So you're not in the, you're in the video?
No. We just shot a video. You already worked out, I thought.
It's like a pump workout.
We just shot a video for Steve's channel. Don't go check that one out. Because they tried to fucking expose me. They brought fake ass weights in here.
I didn't bring nothing.
Yeah, fuck you guys.
We did. We brought fake weights here from Brad's truck.
No. Yeah. That you planted.
Why don't you go check the truck right now?
Are they still in there?
No, I don't know. You would know.
Exactly. Fuck you guys. They planted them on me. When are you posting that?
Next week?
I don't know. Oh, tomorrow. Oh, shit. This
tomorrow.
So, it's yesterday then on our
video.
This is Friday on ours. So, yesterday he posted a video.
It's live right now. So, I exposed Brad Martin for fake weights.
No, he didn't. They brought fake weights in here.
Well, we were just walking by his truck. We were like, that's a really nice truck. You see the bed of it? And then Brad's got his shit in the weights, and then we picked up the weights.
Okay.
This is all accurate, yeah.
This is all fucking
wow.
I literally believe
it. Is this
true? It's very true. I was in here.
This
I was
is
in here
fucking...
Out.
He was here.
And I've looked up to Brad. He's helped me make some gains, but it hurts to see the truth. But
wow, this is funny.
Puking. He was sick to his stomach at what he thought.
Interesting.
Couldn't bear it.
How did I make all these gains with fake weights?
No,
fake gains.
Well, so this is fake too now? Oh my god. Fuck you guys. Let's get a photo.